Hi, my name's Scott Moore. I'm the owner of Bellevue Fine Art Reproduction. At Bellevue Fine Art Reproduction, we specialize in the scanning and reproduction of artwork. We do that using a 4x5 digital scanback camera that looks like a very, very large studio camera, and it's actually got a scanner on the inside. We also use a number of specialized lighting techniques to make sure that your art looks its best. We use cross-polarization and other techniques to make sure that things like oil paintings and acrylic paintings don't have any glare to them. We're able to handle charcoals, pastels, and other difficult to handle art mediums. We have a specialized magnetic wall that allows us to put the artwork up and get a good scan of it without touching the surface of it. We start by scanning your artwork and color correcting it and making sure that it looks like the original, and then reproducing your artwork on different giclée media. So we're very, very in tune with artists' needs when it comes to specialized media. Everything from encaustic media that can't be in a hot spot for too long, to oil paints that may still be a little bit wet, to acrylics and oils that glare, or pastels and charcoals and pencil drawings that can't be touched. Whatever the case may be, all of our staff is highly competent when it comes to handling artwork, and everybody here has a degree in fine art, as well as showing in galleries themselves and reproducing digital artwork. When you come in to have artwork scanned, the process starts by you filling out a form. And we ask you to fill out a form that tells us the title of each piece and its size, which we will check when we actually scan the artwork and make sure that the artwork is handed back to you in a digital form that matches the physical size of the original. All of the artwork that is scanned is produced at 300 pixels per inch. So we ask each artist to fill out the drop-off form so that we know the title and size of each piece. And the title gives us something to name each digital file as we separate the artwork out into individual digital files. In the drop-off form is also a comments area, and in the comments area, the artist can leave notes for special requests they might have for any cleanup that they want in the digital file, whether they want the edges left on watercolor paper or trimmed to the trim lines, whether they want blemishes removed, things, artist mistakes fixed, signatures removed. In restoration cases, we'll be asked to fix tears in paper, water stains, scratches, and all kinds of other imperfections that have happened over the years to historical documents and historical photographs. Once we have scanned the artwork, we open up the digital file and we check it for imperfections. We go through and make sure there are no problems with the image, and then we crop into the artwork, name the file to be what the client had said the title of the piece was, size it, make sure that it is the right size and matches the original, and then we make a proof. The idea of the proof is that the original artwork, the monitor that we're looking at on the editing station, and the physical proof that we print, all three of those things should match. Oftentimes there are some minor discrepancies, or even major discrepancies depending on the paint that was used, between the scan and the original. Certain paints will eat light at different rates, even in the most color calibrated environment, and we have a very color calibrated environment, you'll see shifts in colors. So the proofing process is a way for us to match those colors, make sure they all match the original to the extent possible. Then we let the client know that the job is ready. At this point, we email the client the invoice and a link to a Dropbox folder, which allows them to download the high resolution file, the TIFF file, and the JPEG for each of the scans that we've done, so that they can have immediate access to their files. At this point, if the client wants to make prints, we can start to talk about paper choices and canvas choices. We have a wide variety of paper and canvases, and we can make recommendations to the client about which paper we think they should use or which paper they might like, which we base on trying to make the print look as close to the original as possible. And different papers work better for different mediums. We may have a specific look that we're after for underwater photography. We might recommend iridescent pearl paper, for example, which will shimmer like you would expect underwater. For watercolors, we've got watercolor paper. For oil paint, we've got canvas choices and paper choices that will make the reproduction look as close to the original as possible, no matter what medium was used. With an oil painting, we have different Hanamel papers, like the Hanamel Fine Art Pearl and Photorike Satin. And of course, we've got canvas, different choices for coatings. We always use the finest canvas possible. And we really like the Hanamel line of canvas and papers that we use quite extensively. And for coating, we've got a matte gloss and satin coating we put on the canvas to both protect it and help bring out the colors. Sometimes we will also embellish paintings on oil paintings. Sometimes people ask us to hand coat the canvas with a gel that makes it gives it an impasto look for impasto paintings, or apply some gold or silver or other embellishments to prints that where the original may have had some metallics in it that can't be reproduced. I hope that gives you a good overview of our printing and scanning services here at Bellevue Fine Art Reproduction. If you haven't already done so, please visit our website at www.bellevuefineart.com, where we have a wealth of information to help you use our printing and scanning services, including a print price calculator where you can put in the size of your desired print and margins and pick your paper and see what the cost would be. We have an aspect ratio calculator, which is very helpful if you want to change sizes from your original, file uploads, FAQs, and lots of help videos. Thanks, and have a great day.